الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. So the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إذا كان صوم يوم أحدكم فلا يرفث ولا يصخب ولا يجهل وإن سابه أحد أو شتمه فليقل إني صائم. The messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the hadith meaning is fasting day should not be like any other day. When you start fasting, it's like starting salah. It's like going into ibadah. And if you're in salah, you don't speak the same way. You know, you're reading Quran and you're making dua and you're making sujood and ruku'. Same with fasting. It's not about watching everything or hearing everything or just involving any joke or talking even worse, which is about people. You know, Abu Huraira said that every time the people talk about others, it's called namima, somebody is in their absence, even if it's a silly joke or not so serious, the angels don't know that. They just, it's a video camera on you, so they record it. It rips away in the fasting, you know? It rips in the fasting, and Abu Huraira put the term, says, siyam muraqqa. You get like patched fasting, like a piece of cloth with so many patches in it. He says to seal those patches, because every one of us make mistake, you make istighfar. So he says, better to come with patched fasting than holes in it. So every time you find this, you catch yourself, said something not right or looked at something, it's normal, it's a human thing. You just make istighfar. Says, oh Allah, please, I'm sorry. I'll try my best. I'll control next time. Astaghfirullah. Astaghfirullah means, oh Allah, I am weak, cover up for me. Don't humiliate me in front of others. Don't make people look down at me. Don't make me in front of even, which is worse, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the companion and the believers on the day of judgment. Because it's called Yawm al-Ard. The day of judgment, one of the names is called Yawm al-Ard al-Akbar. You know what is Ard? Presentation. It's the day of presentation, the day you may Allah forgive us and help us and protect us. Your stuff will be presented to 300 billion people. Presented. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us and make us from those who will be dealt with confidentially. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this beautiful hadith. He says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call the believers and yusdil alayhim sitrahu. He will pull the curtain down. Nobody will see the presentation. We'll pull the curtain down between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, أَتَذْكُرْ يَوْمَ كَذَا? You remember this day? You remember this? And the person, because he's a believer, he loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he just was weak. He says, Ya Allah, I remember. And he keeps on Allah reminding him the next page, and the next month, and the next year, and when you're 15, when you're 16, when you're 17, because the Quran says, أَحْصَاهُ اللَّهُ وَنَسُوهُ. Allah keeps records of it, but they forget. Because if it's on record, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us and make it into a good deed. Once you make tawbah and you start to do righteous good deed, Allah is the most generous. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ. Allah will never wish or wanted to punish you. So Allah will keep reminding the person of the mistakes till the person himself or herself think, I'm doomed. There's no way now, after all this list of, you know, mistakes, that I'm going to be forgiven. But Allah at the end will say, سَتَرْتُهَا عَلَيْكَ فِي الدُّنْيَا. I protected you in the dunya, I will also protect you in akhra. I kept it secret in dunya, I will keep it secret in akhra, go to Jannah. So this is the month of forgiveness, you know, this is the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is more than willing than any other time to forgive everything. All we try to do is just to show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we also wanted to be forgiving. So it's the month of seeking forgiveness, saying astaghfirullah, oh Allah please forgive me, oh Allah please forgive me, like that, all day, astaghfirullah, or thanking Allah for the blessing. Thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the blessing, or making the dhikr, just the normal dhikr, glorifying Allah, Ya Allah, you know, you're the creator, you created me, you sustaining me, you providing me, in the language from your heart. In the language from your heart. It should not be just something that you don't understand. Please, just try your very best to talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this month. And you will feel the sweetness. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, for that iman, there is sweetness that you will feel it in your heart. Another last hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that the looks is like, he called it sahm min saham al-shaytan. It is the weapon that the shaitan use against the human being, their eyes. Because the minute you see something, it never leaves your heart. This is the window to your heart. Anything you see on TV, on the mobile, online, it just goes straight to your heart. Finished. It's recorded. So that is the weapon Iblis or shaitan used to distract us. So the believers, as the Prophet ﷺ said, you have the first look that is unintentional. You looked at something wrong, as, oh, astaghfirullah. You look away, Allah immediately puts sweetness in your heart for that action. Abdallahu Allah halawatan. Allah will put in your heart sweetness because of you. No, Allah doesn't like me to look at this stuff. Immediately you feel the sweetness. So this is the time, the Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase our sweetness of iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala beautify the iman in our heart, in our mind, and increase our taqwa. We ask Allah to accept our fasting. We ask Allah to accept our Ramadan. We ask Allah to give us Laylatul Qadr. We ask Allah to make all of us from those who witness Laylatul Qadr with full iman and full taqwa. Wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillah rabbil alameen wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Jazakumullah khairan.